Well, hey there, happy day 88. I like that this is day 88. 88, we're gonna do the challenge process review. We're gonna talk about and simplify the challenge process. We're gonna break it down to a 6-step process instead of kind of the 10-step process that we've been following, sort of dragging out the process that we've gone over it over and over and over again during this 90-day period. And whether you know it or not, or realize it or not, you've actually gone over this process at least 7 times throughout the challenge. Doing that helps to anchor it in your system, in your being, in your understanding, in your conscious and your subconscious, so that as you face challenges, as you go out into the world, because guess what? The one thing that is assured and guaranteed is we will continuously face challenges, problems, obstacles, things that we need to deal with and overcome, or use as stepping stones to take us to the things that we want. So let's review the challenge process today. I have just created it's not really an acronym. I can't think if these are the best letters. I would love feedback and input on this, but I've broken it down to a 6-step process: challenge, position, possibilities, action, results, and process. So that's CPPARP, which doesn't mean anything. And so I might look for different words because I'm continually refining my way of describing and teaching about how to handle challenges. What is the best way to handle challenges? Because all of us in any walk of life, whether it's our health, our lifestyle, our blood pressure, our business, we need to go ahead and always have a quick and easy process for handling things that come up. The faster we can make decisions, we talked about quick decision making the other day, the faster we can make decisions and move on and go through this process, the faster we'll move our life in the direction we want it to go. So the first step is challenge. What is the challenge? What is the obstacle? What is the problem we're facing? First thing we want to do is we want to look at it, and we need to say, what is going on right now? What is the situation right now? And from there, we have to ask ourselves, well, what do we want? What do we want the situation to be? Because if we don't know what we want, anything we do, it won't really matter, because it'll just keep moving us and flim-flamming us through our lives, and we won't know whether we're getting toward what we want or not, because we haven't decided what we want. If I'm going on a vacation and I don't have a destination in mind, any place will do, right? Anywhere I go will give me a break from where I am, and that will suffice. Will it get me to the end point of where I really want to go? If I really want to go to Italy and I end up in Delaware, is that really where I wanted to go? No, because I didn't set my sights on and decide where I wanted to go. So the first part of any challenge is paying attention to where I am. Where are we right now? What is the current situation? And where do I want to go? What do I want the situation to be? The next step is the position step. And what I mean by position is, where are you with respect to this situation? Emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, financially, with respect to contribution, and so all 7 aspects of our life, and relationships. Where are you with your beliefs, your thoughts, your feelings, and your emotions with respect to this particular challenge and topics? So you want to assess all that. So I call that position or place. Where are you in this whole thing? And it's a lot of the woo-woo mindset stuff, but if you don't do that, if you don't know what you believe or what beliefs and feelings and emotions are acting on you with respect to this current challenge, it's pretty hard, if not impossible, to actually resolve it in a way that's best for you. The third step of the process is what I call possibilities. We live in a world of infinite possibilities. So often we think of a problem or a challenge and we've got, well, I either have to do this or it's the end of my world, or the end of my business, or the end of my life, or the end of my health. I have to do 1 of 2, maybe 3. Maybe we're creative enough normally to come up with 3 possible solutions, but that's where we stop. This step is to remind us to research, get more info, model what other people have done, and open ourselves up to the fact that there are a lot of different possibilities of a way that any challenge or any situation can be dealt with. We just have to open ourselves up to be able to see and find those possible solutions. So this is the stage where we're gonna research and we're gonna look at alternatives. The next step is action. In action step, we're gonna pick one of those possible solutions. We're gonna pick one and we're gonna immediately take action on it. We are gonna take action on it and test it and find out if it's gonna get us the next step, the result and the outcomes that we want. Next step is the results. did it give us a positive result or a negative result? If it gave us a negative result, we're going to go back a step, pick another alternative, take action on that, right? If it gave us a positive result, we're going to go to the next step in the process, which is the process step. The process step is where we take the improvement that we've gotten or the solution to the problem, and we define the process, we systematize it, we automate it if possible, we delegate it if we can delegate it to someone else, and we get rid of, if we can get rid of this challenge or problem once and for all, we're going to do that. But the process doesn't end there. The overall challenge process doesn't end. Because why? We're always going to have more problems or obstacles or challenges coming our way. So what do? We just repeat the process. We identify the problem, the challenge. What's the challenge? What is it? What's the situation right now? What do I want it to be? What do I want the outcome to be? Again, where am I in this situation? What's my position in my place? What are the different possibilities? What action am I going to take and test? And then what results do I get? If it's the result I want, I'm going to automate that. I'm going to take it and make it a process. Or I'm going to solve it by getting rid of the problem once and for all. So that's the process. Six-step process. Challenge, position, possibilities, action, results, process. And that's it. So what are we going to do today? All you have to do is look at and understand the overall process today, and then comment below what you think of CPPARP as the process steps for this particular thing, this particular process. I want some feedback on that. And if you understand what I'm saying when I summarize each of those steps, do you think there's something missing? Do you think over the 90 days that we've covered something over and over and over again that isn't summarized in this six-step process? If you do, share that in the comments below. If you have any questions about this, questions about the process, if you've seen and are seeing yourself apply the process in other areas of your life, not just in this challenge, I would love to know about that. That's it. That's our challenge for today. We're keeping it simple because we're winding down. We're getting to the end, and I just wanted to do a process overview and review. I think when I first explained it, we did it as a 10-step process. Now, why did we do that? Because it's a 90-day challenge, and if we did it as a 5 or 6-step process, we'd go through it like 20 times, and that would be like 20 different things we'd focus on. It's too much. It's too much. So we want to pare things down and simplify. So instead of being the 10-step process that we actually went through over and over and over again, we've pared it down to the 6-step process, the 6 steps that are the most important, and that if we do those, we'll be able to handle any challenge that comes our way. So love some feedback on this. Go ahead, let me know what you think of CPPARP, and if it's just plain confusing, and if the steps are just plain confusing, let me know that as well. Otherwise, have an absolutely amazing day, and I'll, of course, be with you tomorrow with day 89 of our challenge. I like 88 because the numbers 8 are the infinity symbol, and they mean infinite possibilities, and that's why I love that this landed on day 88, because we forget sometimes of our infinite possibilities in solving any problem or dealing with any challenge, and we think that we only have a couple solutions, and that is just so not true. All right, catch you tomorrow.